Quick AmbaSat update. Here's the AmbaSat with the sensor number 6. This is a UV sensor. It is connected now with a programmer that has a DTR pin. This goes off to a computer, and that computer is running Visual Studio Code with the example for sensor number 6, which is working. The next thing we did is to use a LoPi set up as a nano gateway for the Things network as an external antenna. This is running off a battery, and it works. This is what a packet looks like in the packet inspector in the applications, and this is what packets look like received in the gateway data view. We noticed we're only getting one packet at a time, and there's a reason for that. The three packets that are sent out are the satellite status, the sensors that are on board the main board, and then what's called the mission sensor, the small sensor board that's attached. In our case, it's sensor number 6, the UV board. So those are three packets that are sent out consecutively. And as you can see from this video, they are sent out on different channels. The nano gateway only has one channel, and that's why we can only receive one at a time. So if we want to receive all three of these packets, we could set up three nano gateways or go ahead and borrow a full gateway with the 8 channels. The software that we're using in AmbaSat is from a community member named Michael Compreth. We could modify the software in order to get around this limitation, but we'd really like to use it directly off of GitHub. So why are we doing this? Well, a couple of reasons. It's always good to learn about space-related hardware. The AmbaSat is open source, and we want to help improve it. There's two ways that we are trying to improve AmbaSat. First, we would like to add to the collection of sensors. The sensors that we want to make are amateur radio related. The AmbaSat platform is very, very small and lightweight, could be very good for ballooning and other applications like that. Another thing that we'd like to address is the closed components, the use of LoRa. We would like to see if we can respin the board with an open system, open design, to address some of the issues that people have raised about the use of a LoRa-based system. And those are the reasons why. So there's actually three. You know, just learning about a system and the amateur radio components for the sensor that attaches to the main board, and improving the main board in terms of openness.